grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Sheila died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. My brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our sister, that she may share in Christ's victory, and let us pray for ourselves, that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it's our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Sheila Moore, who has gone to rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
From the book of Psalms, Psalm 23, a psalm of David. Adonai is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He has me lie down in grassy pastures. He leads me by quiet water. He restores my inner person. He guides me in right paths for the sake of his own name. Even if I pass through death, dark ravines, I will fear no disaster, for you are with me. Your rod and staff reassure me. You prepare a table for me, even as my enemies watch. You anoint my head with oil from an overflowing cup. Goodness and grace will pursue me every day of my life, and I will live in the house of Adonai for years and years to come. From the book of Revelation. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the old heaven and the old earth had passed away, and the sea was no longer there. Also I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared like a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. I heard a loud voice come from the throne, "See, God's Shekinah is with mankind, and he will live with them, for they will be his peoples, and he himself, God with them, will be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will no longer be any death, and there will no longer be any mourning, crying or pain, because the old order has passed away." Then the one sitting on the throne said, "Look, I am making everything new." Also he said, "Write, these words are true and trustworthy." And he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To anyone who is thirsty, I myself will give water free of charge from the fountain of life. He who wins the victory will receive these things, and I will be his God, and he will be my son." These are the words of the Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, "I tell you most solemnly, whoever listens to my words and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life. Without being brought to judgment, he has passed from death to life. I tell you most solemnly, the hour will come, in fact it is here already, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and all who hear it will live. For the Father, who is the source of life, has made the Son the source of life. And because he is the source, Son of Man, has appointed him supreme judge. Do not be surprised at this, for the hour is coming when the dead will leave their graves at the sound of his voice. Those who did good will rise again to life." This is the gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, I take this opportunity to express deep sentiments of condolences to Sheila's children, grandchildren, and all the family members and friends. At this moment of great sorrow, Sheila's voice heard at the time of entrance is marvelous and extraordinary. I don't have much experience with her except visiting her in the Emerton Park for the past 1 year. But all I heard about her appears to me that she was a great lady and a very good mother and a faithful Christian and follower of Christ. The readings she herself chosen today to be read in this Mass is to give consolation to us all. Because once a person leaves this world, no one knows what's happening, where the person goes. But she had confided total faith in Christ. Because of her strong faith, the reading she has chosen is, "Do not be afraid, don't be sad. I am in a very good place. A new heaven and a new earth, a new Jerusalem indeed, a new life with God." What other consoling words We require, dear brothers and sisters, when Sheila is in the presence of God. The gospel that we have heard today, the assurance of Jesus, whoever listens to my words and believes has eternal life. Still further, the reading concludes, those who did good will rise again to life. No doubt, Sheila, as a good lady, might have done good works in her life. She has been an active member in this Catholic community, and she helped the people to praise and honor God through her beautiful voice. And her acts of charity, her good works, are rewarding factors for her before God. Let us continue to pray for the repose of her soul. May God grant her eternal love, joy, and peace. Amen.
God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Our mother, sister, was given the promise of eternal life in baptism. Lord, give her communion with your saints forever. Lord, hear us. Mum ate the bread of eternal life, the body of Christ. Raise her up, Lord, at the last day. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear
us. Our sister was a great one on the earth. Welcome her, Lord, into the sanctuary of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear
us. We pray for our brothers and sisters, our relatives, for all who are close to us and good to us. Lord, give them the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for all who have died in the hope of rising again. Welcome them, Lord, in the light of your presence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for all who have gathered here to worship in faith. Lord, make us one in your kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Let us pray. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Bring
them out to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Julian, Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Sheila Moon, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced in our life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Please stand for the Lord's Prayer. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, lest thou be called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. The process of thinking about any person and their eulogy is complex for many reasons. First of all, for me, is the emotion that is not fully controlled or stable. And secondly, how much can you really say in a few minutes that vaguely reflects that person's life? The person in this case is Sheila Mary Moore, my mother, and the mother of my siblings. She's been a major part of all of our lives for many years now, and with that has come a great many memories. In fact, she had some 91 years and 4 months of memories. Most are happy, but there have also been many sad memories. I think some of the saddest memories for Mum included the premature death of her husband and best friend, Jeff, in 1980 to cancer. But possibly even more than that were the deaths of 4 of her children before her own sad passing on Friday the 31st of July. I believe that Mum never truly got over their deaths. Fortunately, Mum had an amazing faith all of her life. I wouldn't describe her as an overly religious person, but I know she lived her life to the teachings of Christ and strongly held on to the belief that she would once again see and be with those loved ones who had passed before her. This faith has given her great strength throughout her life and helped her make sense of things when times were really tough. And in saying that, I remember a huge number of Sundays where we had priests and nuns and whatever for dinner, so it was a fairly common experience throughout our lives as kids. Mum was many things. She could turn a hand to most things, and age was not a limiter for her. She learned to drive in her late 20s, and that has a number of stories in its own right. She started to play golf in her 50s, and of course lawn bowls as well, and did well in both. She travelled overseas after Dad died, and I for one was surprised at that, as she has shown no urgency to do that when we were younger. That for me would have been the perfect time to travel, as it could not have been easy for her, having given birth to 10 children over a period of 21 years. The serenity of getting away. Home for us growing up was always busy and sometimes very noisy. It was exciting and fun, and Mum and Dad worked themselves into the ground to keep us all happy, fed and safe. Mum was the best cook, as my own slight frame can attest. She made the best sponge cakes I ever had, and the smell of them coming home from school was more than I could bear. And when I used to tell my brother Tony, for those who know him, that the sponge cakes had mixed peel in them, just so that we could get to them first. The only thing that Mum didn't deal well was the sight of blood. Given there were 9 boys and 1 girl, there were, in fact, many occasions where blood was clearly shed from accidents and just being kids. And there were occasions we had to pick Mum off the floor after one of those, such an incident. Mum made sure that we as kids shared her own heritage growing up, and we were not just visitors to Irishtown, but an integral part of our maternal grandparents' lives and the lives of our Uncle Ray and Auntie Carmel and their wonderful families as well as the community. Most of the boys played football with Irishtown, but oddly our one sister, Deb, wasn't interested. Thank you, Mum and Dad, for all of that. They will stay as wonderful memories for all of us. For those who don't know already, Mum planned her own funeral down to music, hymns, carriers, how she wanted to end her days on this earth. I don't mean that in any morbid sense, but Mum was nothing if not practical. Mum and one of her dear friends, Sheila Krushka, put together a few cassette tapes of the hymns and music she wanted a number of years ago in preparation for her funeral. The music was duly sung and played with great gusto and put on cassette tape, supported on one track by my brother Ken. I think Mum might have overestimated the youthful lifespan of cassettes, or perhaps she thought she would get to use them in their heyday. Regardless of that, we have in the last few days managed to digitise the music, and what you have listened to so far and throughout this funeral is our Mum singing at her own funeral. I, for one, have never experienced this and probably never will again. This was Mum. I am sure if she had thought back when she gave me my severe instructions, I might tell you, that there would be such a thing as a photo celebration of her life, She would have possibly done that too, although she was possibly the most photo-averse person I've ever known. If you took any sort of camera near her when she was younger, she could disappear faster than Houdini. If you actually managed to trap her through her own sheer dogged tiredness or through surprise, she had the uncanny knack of blinking at the precise time you pressed the shutter button, which was extremely frustrating for the snapper, but I wondered sometimes if maybe she managed that too. The advent of smartphone and age limit her ability to escape, and so many of the photos you will see today are from a more recent period. I always loved her smile and the sparkle in her eyes. As was typical, Mum gave me a list of instructions, and I want to share some of those with you today, as they are not just relevant to my family. Don't undermine your worth by comparing yourself to others. It is because we are different that each of us is special. Don't set your goals by what other people deem important. Only you know what is best for you. Don't take for granted the things closest to your heart. Cling to them as you would your life, for without them, life is meaningless. Don't let your life slip through your fingers by living in the past or the future. By living your life in the present, one day at a time, you live all the days of your life. Don't give up when you still have something to give. Nothing is really over. Mum also had a message for her immediate family that I will share with them now. God bless all my grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and my great-great-grandchildren. You're all precious to me. Sorry. I love you all very much and hope you all have happy lives. Thank you all for being good children, and I thank God every day for all of you. I have been very blessed with a good husband and good children, and I thank God for every day I have had with you. I was also blessed with wonderful parents, brother and sister. God has been good to me, and I thank him every day for all the blessings I have received. God bless you and all your families. I knew there was a reason I didn't want to do this, but and I think this is it. On behalf of my brothers and myself, I would like to thank everybody for coming to celebrate Mum's life today. She would almost certainly be embarrassed, but would have secretly been very humbled and touched by your tribute. Sorry to our dear family members, caught in Victoria, who cannot be here in person due to COVID-19 restrictions, but Parkside Funerals is streaming this to you via YouTube to watch. Love to you all and stay safe. And since this morning we've found that some of our other dear family have been stuck in Hobart and not able to actually attend this afternoon due to snow, so that's a pain. I understand that Mum's friend Sheila, who now lives in Queensland, may also be watching. Hope you like the music, Sheila. Been a long time since you two sang together. From myself, I sincerely thank my brothers Tony and Ron in particular for the enormous amount of work they have done in the past few days to ensure this is a fitting and proper send-off for Mum. Mum wanted, as part of her instructions, to be dressed in a nice nightie and a shroud for today. Nothing too fancy. She was a bit like that though, wasn't she? Sadly, we were not able to find a shroud in her belongings after she died, and it's really difficult. I don't know whether anyone's ever tried to actually sort of to race around to Kmart or Target or somewhere and buy a shroud, but they just don't. They just not there, sadly. So I sincerely thank my wife, Kate, for going above and beyond and creating a lovely shroud for Mum so she could have what she wanted at not much more than a minute's notice. I thank Kate and my own children for their significant contribution, including sorting and copying photos to ensure this is a happy day, and for their ongoing support of me. A final and sincere thank you to the wonderful staff of Everton Park, who have been Mum's day-to-day support and lifeline for many years, for all you did for her and for us. Thank you, Father Christopher, for coming to give Mum the last rites before she passed, and for being here to help celebrate her life and her passing. Mum requested that following this mass, she be taken for cremation, and that her ashes be placed with our beloved father, so there will be no graveside ceremony. Rest in peace, Mum. Thanks, everyone.
David Clay.
please stand. Let us pray. May participation in this heavenly sacrament obtain perpetual life and rest for Sheila Mary Moore. We pray, O Lord. Bring her along with the angels to the fullness of your everlasting glory through Christ our Lord. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present to her to God the Most High. May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister, Sheila Mary Moore, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Amen. May the angels of the Lord lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city Jerusalem, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Whoever believes in me, even though the person dies, shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.